troubles will come and they will pass.
Glad to have you back for another episode of Whitetail Bushcraft Outfitters. We're going to continue on with the deer hide tanning today, guys. I'm going to show you the next steps in the process, so stay tuned and we'll be right back with you. Back in the shack, guys, getting ready to work on that hide some more. Give you a look at Eustace. He's actually doing pretty good. Still haven't let him go yet. I don't think I'm gonna. But he's doing real good. That's that one I rescued. People have been asking about him. Let me get out of the shadows there. But I'm gonna get started on this hide. Alright guys, what I've been doing a little bit is working this hide so you can still see it soft. It's been on there, that egg mayonnaise and or vegetable oil mix has been on here about 48 hours I'd say. Kind of let it in a little longer than usual. I'm using a wire brush. I'm not trying to dig into that hide. I'm just trying to perforate a little bit to make sure it soaks in good. Is what I've been doing, trying to work it a little bit. The hide looks like it stayed on, so we'll see what happens. And this might take off any little extra stragglers. And what this helps does is grab it and work it. Me and Sean worked it over a tree also. And on the next step, I'm going to start washing it up. I'm still debating on salting it. Usually salting it, well, you'll end up stiffening it up, but it does dry it out quickly. But before you'd want to salt this, if you want to make this soft enough to where you can use it as wearable clothing or something, or like a cape, you definitely want to work it and work it to the softness you like, because it is going to stiffen some when you salt it. A close up of that. Alright, guys, all I'm using now is some warm water and maybe a drop of dish detergent in it. We're going to start washing this thing off. Once we've finished everything, we can use a little bleach once the thing's completely cured and done. See, that's just regenerating all that tanning solution that we made up. You may have to do this several times till it's actually cleaned off, but I'm gonna actually work it some more before this thing dries. I'm gonna try to get this as soft as possible. I'll show you my other one I have for a bedroll. Thank you. that hide don't, or hair don't slip, we're in good shape, guys. I'm probably going to take it off the board and work it a little bit, see how that hair is actually holding up, so stay tuned. Got this hide spread out. Looks like the fur is staying on pretty good. Hair, whatever you want to call it. So far, it's not sliding, which is a good sign. Real good sign. I'm really debating on salting it. I know I'm going to smoke it next, but I still want to work this a little bit. So none of it's sliding so far. So far, so good. Sure is a pretty hide. Give you guys a little bit closer look up of that. So far that mayonnaise, egg, and vegetable oil seems to be working pretty good. Let me show you what I mean. Working it, guys. I'm just gonna keep twisting and working this hide, scrunching it, stretching it back out. It's almost acting like a suction cup on this concrete floor, but I want to work it to where at the same rate I can be testing it that the hide's not gonna slip. And so far looks like it's gonna stay in there good, or the hair's not gonna slip. I keep saying hide, but I want to flip this back over, guys. Work it some more on that other end to get it on the other side to kind of get it look like buckskin is what I'm trying to get a look to. And we'll keep you posted. And definitely we'll be smoking it also. This is the one I was talking about that I made up about 5 years ago, but this was a brain tan with salted and then a brain tan. This one came out stiff, and that's pretty much how I wanted it to come out. This one's actually stiff for a bed roll. That way when you're laying on the ground on it, as you can see, this one's pretty stiff. It's like a raw, almost like a rod, but it's still durable, you know what I mean? But this one's more for laying on, kind of give you a barrier from the cold and rocks and twigs and all that. That was a nice looking deer also. That's about 5 years old. Real pretty hide. I got this one real early in the season. It was like the second day of hunting season for us. Second day of bow season in Ohio about 5 years ago. Well, I'm going to get back out in the garage and check out the one we've been we had hanging. So stay tuned. Alright guys, I've had this thing hanging. We did the cleaning on it. I've had this thing hanging for about 2-3 days. And as you can see, this thing's real nice and soft. Real nice and soft. We also used a little bit of soap on it just to clean it up some. But no salt whatsoever. Normally, in a traditional way, what you'd want to do is flesh it. Then you'd want to salt it, then you'd want to do your tanning. You know, cleaning it after you salt it, then you'd want to do your tanning, and then clean it again. The cleaner you get it, the better tan you're going to end up with. With this one, I just want to do it as kind of primitive as possible. I used that one knife, that Hi-Q Mora. Actually, that's the one that I used to field dress it, flesh it, and tan it. I ended up not having to use the fleshing knife whatsoever. I don't have the mower out here, but I didn't have to end up using this fleshing knife at all on this hide at all. But this thing came out super pliable. So it's more like a blanket or clothing. It's still damp, but I'm going to keep working it, and all we're going to do is just keep twisting it. Me and Sean's going to get this thing and just twist it all up. Compared to this one, which I showed you before, a little earlier on the video, this one's kind of hard, bendable, But I use this as, you know, a ground roll that I lay on, or you could actually have it on for a actual wall hanger also. But this one here, I think it's gonna make an awesome, awesome cable.
Pull this off for you.
You can see this thing. It's got the collar. You bring it up and over. It'll be a pretty cool cape on it. If I can get the other ends of it. Got these. You trim this up. It'll be a pretty awesome cape, guys. I'm real proud of Sean getting this deer all by himself, getting it on video, the whole nine yards. But be a pretty cool cape. We'll work something out and make it work. Well, until next time, guys, I'm Nick with Whitetail Bushcraft Outfitters. We'll catch you on the next video. And the actual next part of this video, step three, will be smoking this. And we'll kind of make a teepee out of it. And while we're at it, we might as well smoke up some venison if I get a chance. We've been having some rain lately. So right now, I'm just going to strictly let this hang for a couple more days. And then we'll smoke it up and get a nice, you know, bronzy tan on the back of this thing. So take care, guys.